So, okay, a lot of companies probably have observability strategies already implemented. What separates good tools from bad?
Most customers do something in the observability area, but what they do is they create some custom tools, or they use tools which were developed for applications which were not built in this era, right? And over a period of time, and by the way, this happens to us as well. So I'm not just saying, you know, we are perfect, but there's always, it's progress not being perfect, right? So what happens is teams become silos. You know, they work in silos, they have different tools. You don't have, you know, the right hand is not doing the same thing that the left hand is doing. It's like two different things. They don't know what they're doing. People keep throwing more and more resources at it and more money at it, at the problem, rather than saying, you know what, I'm going to standardize, right? Let me provide my line of business and my development teams a standardized set of tools. And once I have that standardized set of tools, they don't have to, your actual application developers and your business doesn't have to go figure out what observability tool I should use. It's all there, right? And usually it's done by CIOs and CTOs. They set the strategy. So have a strategy that where you're thinking about observability as a day zero problem. And when you're building your infrastructure and your IT landscape, your data landscape, make sure observability is part of it. Then the teams using those infrastructure, they don't have to worry about observability. It's all there from day one.
You mentioned something about predicting a downtime or predicting something going wrong. So predictive analysis with observability is, I'm assuming, one of the biggest parts of the function, right? You want, this is what people want. Do you have any examples, like specific examples? You don't have to name any names, but any specific examples where you caught something that was about to happen that would have been catastrophic?
Absolutely. So I'll give you an example of application performance, right? So we have hundreds of thousands of customers using applications that they have come to depend on every day, like the ones I gave you examples of, like banking, retail, transportation, ticketing, and so on. By using the right observability tools, at least the customers that we work with that use them, we see a significant drop in the outages as well as disruptions, right? If these observability tools and strategies are implemented from day zero. I'll give you another example. Our own IBM SRE teams, we operate environments where we have services that our customers have come to expect continuous resiliency 24/7. And how do we ensure we provide that level of service? So now we can measure ourselves the amount of time that it takes to automatically, say, rotate certificates, right? Automatically apply patching to common vulnerabilities. We don't have to wait for 2 weeks or 4 weeks to address a particular vulnerability. We can do automated patching now. So all of these, you know, I can definitely say that has reduced the number of tickets customers open with us. That's a great area of measurement. And we also look at disruptions, how many times an application went down. Yes, it's up 99.999% of the time, but, you know, are customers using it the way we expect them to use it? Are we, you know, hearing complaints? All of those things automatically just dropped out. The certificate example that I gave you, in a given year, and this is a favorite metric I have, it's not a good one, but in a given year, we get about anywhere from 700 to 1,000 tickets where customers are calling us saying, hey, my application went down. I have no idea why it went down. So having observability tools helps you. Remember I told you about root cause analysis? So we can pinpoint why an application went down. And two, we can actually help manage your certificates. We can actually help rotate those certificates automatically. You probably don't even need a change management system in place because you're not going to let your application certificate expire before you're going to rotate it, right? So that's, again, a great example. And, you know, we do see the number of tickets completely going down, especially the ones that allow us to automate these actions. I would say it probably came down to even zero, but that is a significant drop, 700 to 1,000 a year, down to maybe the teens right now.